Good morning everyone. Today I'll be talking about how you can model the relaxation profiles. So before going into that, suppose you have done the experiments in triplicate. So you select your samples. Now after selecting the samples, you import it into the Exponent Light software over here like this. Now select all the three samples in this panel so that all of them are highlighted, and after you have got this one, you go to process data. In the process data, you come to average. In the average, you go for create data, create. So you will be getting you want to create an average, and which file name you want to give. I want to give a file name of average, and I would like to save this one in my desktop. So I would say auto save, and I will give the path. After I have given the path, just click OK. So if you see, there is another data which has been opened up. So before proceeding further, what I will do is that I will delete all the other data from here. So remove selected from window. Okay, so once you do that, only the average data, it is present over here. Now once you have done this, go to file, go to export, and click spreadsheet. So we do not need the distance information, so we can uncheck the distance information, and then we will click OK. Okay, so we know we have done the experiment up to 65 seconds. So in the time frame, I will go up to 65 seconds. Let me scroll down to 65 seconds. So from here, I will select the data, Control Shift, and I will just copy the data from here, and I will take the data in sheet in an Excel file, paste it. Now I'm just changing the axis so that for my convenience. So I have the time information and the force information. Now we only for the process of modeling, we just only need the relaxation profiles. And I know that I have compressed the samples for a period of 5 seconds. So I will go up to 5 seconds and see over here. If you see, at the maximum force which have been achieved has been 216 at 5 seconds. So the data above this one are redundant for us, so we need to delete this one. Then what I will do, I will be calculating, copying all this file, will cut it, and I will paste it from the time unit 0. Okay, so once I have done this, let me delete the other time information also. So if you look over here, we have got data up to 60 seconds, right? Now we have done the relaxation profile for the 60 seconds, so that's why we are interested in this one. Okay, so once we have done this, what I will do is that I will normalize the data, because for modeling purposes, normalization is one of the best way to do the modeling. Okay, so I will click equals to force data divided by again this maximum force data followed by the pressing of F4. So when I have pressed the F4, if you see over here, I have got a dollar sign between before C and dollar sign before 2. So this means I am arresting this cell. Okay, for in that dividend in the denominator portion. So if we click this one, so after this, bring your cursor to this dotted point and double click over here. So all the remaining data will be prefilled. Now the thing is that if you look into the second cell, what has happened in this first cell, you are having C2 divided by $C2 divided by $C2. But in the second case, the first one, the worst value has become C3 instead of C2, and the denominator portion, it has become, it has remained the same. So this is what it, we call it fixing the cell. So once the cell is being fixed, we do this. Now we have this data. So what I will do is that I will copy this data in a fresh manner separately. We will copy this data also separately over here. Now while doing this, I will just go for the special options, only values. So once I have done this, I will copy this one, and after copying this one, I will take the data in origin. I will paste the data. Let us select the data, then let us go for the analysis. In the analysis, we will go to signal processing and then decimation. So in decimation, you can go for open dialog. So over here in this pane, you check the auto preview. So auto preview is necessary to see that the nature of your data does not change. The reason being, in some cases, what happens if you decimate too far, then the nature of the curve changes. In our experiment, we have seen if we do the decimation at the level of 70, that means we do the resampling at 70 points, then we get reasonably good information and our data is also low enough and we can go for good quality fitting. So click this one. So you will be getting the x-axis and y-axis value which has been decimated. Now copy this value. We have decimated this values. Then we will copy the value, copy full precision. Then we will go to the Excel sheet and then we will open up a new sheet where I have given up this time, normalized force values, fit and SD. So over here I will just copy the data. So if you see, we have got the data over here. Now once we have got the data, we have to do the fitting. Now fitting has to be done with this model. This is a Richard model of viscoelasticity model. So over here, your PT is the variation of the force values over time, and P0, P1, P2, these are the elastic components, whereas tau 1 and tau 2 are related with the viscous components of the dashboards in the Wishart model. So we need to predict P0, P1, tau 1, P2 and T2. So let's put up these values: P0, P1, tau 1, P2, tau 2. Okay. Now, what we have to do is that we have to fit the data. So fitting will be done in this fashion: equals to P0. We want to fix this data over here. So press F4 plus P2 F4 multiplied by exponent minus t. T is a continuous variable, so we don't want to fix this data, divided by tau 1. We have to fix this data, then close the bracket, again close the bracket. Now after we have done this, I will just copy it now for the sake of my convenience to put up the P2 and tau 2 value. So P2 is in P6, H6 this thing, and tau 2 is in the H7 value. So I will just change the numbers so that I can get it easily. So press enter, then auto populate all the thing. So you can see all the things has been auto populated And now let us put the values arbitrarily as p1, 1, 1, 1. And then we have to calculate the squared difference. Squared difference is nothing but the square of the difference between normalized force and the model fit data. So again, autopopulate it. Then we have to calculate SSD, which is sum of squared differences. So click auto sum. By default, it will give you these values that it wants to add up these values, but we don't want these values. We want the squared difference values to be added up. So we will just select this one and then control shift all the values, put enter, it will come like this. Next is you have to create a graph, scattered graph. Go to insert, scatter graph. So before coming to that, you select the time and normalized force. After selecting this, you go to the scatter plot. You do it, so you get a scatter plot. So now then you what you do, you plot the other, you increase the what you call range of your data so as to accommodate the fit data also, to visually see whether your data are fitting over each other or not. So under the current approximations, you will find that it is not fitting up. So what I will do is that I will look into the P0 values. Usually the P0 value is around this residual values, normalized residual values, and it is approximately 0.17. So I will change the value to that one, then 0.5. If you see, I am changing this one, so it has come near, somewhat nearby. So let's change it furthermore. So let it keep it as P1 as P 0.3, and rest of the things it looks good enough. Now over here, what you have to do is that you go to data. After going to data, you have to click solver. If solver is not present in your this solver and data analysis apps are not present over here, you have to go to file. After going to file, you have to go to options. So this window of Excel options will be coming up. Click on add-ins. So as you click on add-in, this window will open up, and then you have to click in the manage section, Excel add-ins, click go. So as you open up this window, this add-ins window opens up, and you have to check analysis tool pack and solver add-in pack, and then click OK. So after you do that, these two should be visible to you. Now we have to click the solver. Now it says we have to set an objective. So our objective is our SSD, sum of squared differences, and we have to make it minimum. So click on the minimum. Then by changing variable cells, which variables we want to change? We want to change this variables. So see, it has automatically come over here. Now what I will do, I will just copy it. The reason being, there is another things we have to do, which is called the subject to the constraints. Are there any constraints for this one? Yes, there is a constraint. All these values should be greater than equal to 0. So I will add up that thing. You can select from here also like this, or you can just copy paste it, because I have already copied it. So I have just I can also paste it. So it should be greater than equal to 0. So this constraint has been set for me. Then I will click OK. Then after I have clicked OK, I will click solve. So see, there is some problem. So it has not solved it, and the data has gone wayward. So what I will do in tau 2, I will just put 0.5 again. So it is giving me something. So again, so okay, 0.25. So we have to play in around somewhere. 0.5, 0.55. Okay. Then tau 1, 2, 3. Again, go to solver. Now see, just by slight playing around, it has now fitted the data completely. So this is our parameter. Okay. Now, next we have to see what is the correlation between the actual data and the fit data. So for that we have to go to the data analysis, then we have to go to correlation, and in the correlation after that we click OK. So it is asking for the input range, so click the original and fit data. So it has selected the ranges, then click on the output range. So I want to have it here, so I have just clicked the cell over here, then click OK. So if you see, the R square value is in this case 0.9909. okay. Then for compilation of data, I would suggest to go in this fashion. You place R square over here, so write R2, then equals to this value, you put it. Okay. Now what I will do is that I will take this data, copy it, and in a new sheet I will just I will just paste the values over here. So P0, P1, P2 and R square values are there. So what I will be having, so say sample, this is for the sample 0. Then similarly you just copy the other values, S1, S2 and so on. So you will be having all the parameters tabulated over here. Okay. So thank you very much for your kind attention.